Alrighty, there's the window and we're going to finish it up now. So what we're going to do is we're going to put the window pane aside for the moment. And we're going to take the frame. We've got it all polished and clean and everything now. Flip it over. We've got to get some screen on there. Alright, Vintage Trailer Supply again. Vintage Trailer Supply is where you can get this. You can get it at the hardware store. But the hardware stores only sell aluminum for the most part. I haven't seen a hardware store that sells this type of galvanized aluminum screening. This stuff is tough, and you can get it in two basic colors. You can get shiny, which I don't like, or you can get this gray stuff. It's a dull finish. I like that better because when you're out in the sun, you're sitting inside the trailer getting out of the heat or whatever, that shiny stuff tends to glare a lot, so I don't really like it. I like this stuff much better. So they come in a roll like this, and it's, boy, this is probably enough for two trailers easy. So basically what you want to do is, remember your metal cutters that you got at Home Depot? They work good for this too. So basically what we're going to do is we're going to lay this over our work. And we're going to try and get it as straight as we can, parallel with our work. We're going to overhang it, oh, maybe an inch on this side. Okay? We're going to try and make sure that we got it as square as possible. There's a reason for that. The reason is mainly because this stuff bends in two directions and no more. So you want it square. And we're going to go ahead and cut it. I can find it here. And we'll go over by, you know, an inch, inch and a half in the other way too. Now keep any of your scrap because, you know, as you know, there's other windows that are smaller that might you might be able to use this scrap on. Go ahead and put this away. There's a couple of tricks to installing this screen. I had to learn them all the hard way because nobody taught me. Okay, now we'll go ahead and minimize our scrap by pulling it down and getting it close, a lot closer. We'll get it parallel. There we go. And here's how I start. You need one of these. You can get these at Ace Hardware for $5. You buy them at Vintage Trailer Supply, they're going to be $15. So on this end, I suggest you buy this at Home Depot or Ace Hardware, and you get the screen at Vintage Trailer Supply just because you can't get it at Ace Hardware or Home Depot. Now what I'm going to do is bring the top down here to about within a, you know, a half an inch. That's really all we need. And I'm going to slide it over to where basically it's centered side to side. Okay? And what we're going to do is, a lot of people would think, oh, well, you just go ahead and do that with it. Well, that's not going to work. It'll all run off different directions and stuff. So what you do, and you'll get better at this with practice. So if you mess up the first screen, don't worry about it. The stuff's not that expensive. You can do it again. Get a hold of it about an eighth of an inch over the end of the lip. And then push it in like this. Okay? Don't roll it. Just push it in. Get it in there real good. And then just roll it back and forth a little bit. Okay? Just enough to hook it in there and make it grab. And you'll feel it. You'll know when it's in there good and solid. Then go to the other side. Pull it not real tight because you'll pull it right out of there and you don't want to stretch the screen either. Just pull it enough so that it's solid here. Nice and flat, okay? Put your hands on top of it here. Hold it there and even push just a little bit, okay? And do the same thing. Hook your screen tool into it and push it down in there. And go back and forth a little bit until it's in there all the way. And you'll know because you'll feel it. Now, by the way, these screen tools have two of these wheels. One wheel has a groove in it. That's for when you have the kind of screens that have that little rubber thing that goes all the way around and holds the screen in. That's not what you use on this. Use the solid one, see? It doesn't have that little groove in it. Okay, now that you have the two sides attached, you go ahead and do the same thing on the other direction. You can start on either side, it doesn't matter, but go ahead and hold it with your hand like this, making it tight so it doesn't move. Stick that thing in there, go back and forth a couple of times. And then you just go ahead, and I got to walk around the camera. Go ahead, you're doing this in the middle. Do the same thing. Get it hooked in there. Run that thing back and forth a little bit, okay? Now you basically got it. You've got the screen where it needs to be, and it's all square, lined up with the frame. You can start moving all of this stuff under the lip that's going to hold it. Now I want you to go to the outside end, do the same thing you did in the middle. Press that stuff in there, just go back and forth a little bit. Do that in every corner. On one side first. Of course I got to walk all the way around the camera. And do the same thing in the other corner. Opposite of the one that you just messed with, the one that you just got nice and tight in there. See? Now you do the same thing on the sides. Go to the corner, fix it. Go to this corner, and fix it. Go to the other side, go to the corner, fix it. Every time you do one of these, it's tightening this screen up more and more. Go to this corner. Now fix it. Alright, now you're locked in on all corners. Let's go to the top. And we're going to start doing the same thing in between everywhere that we've already done it to get it locked in even more. Now you can actually start pushing the screen in all the way. But you can't just run it because it'll run off. So as you see, I'm just going around and affixing it everywhere that it's not affixed. And I'm being careful not to let it run off. So first we go to the middle. Get it in there. Looks like I forgot one. So I'm going to get it now. Never did do this one. Okay, we'll go in between the two, and go all the way, see? Same here, we'll get it in there, go in between the two, go all the way. Do the same thing up here, get the middle. Okay, go in between the two, go all the way. Go back here, go in between the two, go all the way. Now this whole bottom is in now. See? You want to go past the end, you're all locked in there. We're going to go back to the top again and make sure it's all good and tight. Always start in the middle between the two other spots you already did. Get it in there. See how it gets sucked in there? Again, you'll feel it when it's right. Now we'll get the sides. Go in between the two. Get it locked. Go in between the two. Get it locked. Then do the whole side. Now if you want to take a look, maybe, you can't see it. I'll show it afterwards. But I've got this thing all nice and square. So these little tiny 32nd of an inch square holes are all lined up all the way down. And that's what you want. You want it square. Let's go to this side. Do the same thing. You're locked in there. Go past the corner. Even around the corner. See? Go around the corner. Lock it in. Make sure you're on top of it. Not underneath. Same here. Lock in all four corners. None of this is sharp, so you're not going to hurt yourself. I know I can hurt myself playing with cotton balls, so if I tell you you're not going to hurt yourself, don't take my word for it. You might be as bad as I am. There we are. Now our screen is in there. It's tight. You could bounce a quarter on that. Now all we got to do is trim it. To trim it, we're going to do this. Take the same set of scissors. And this is kind of fun. We don't even have to do the top here because it's all the way in. That's why I only brought it up like not even a half an inch, about 3/8 of an inch. So we don't even have to do the top. So we're going to start here. Just tilt the cutters to the side. Let a little screen hang out. It's okay. Doesn't matter. Nobody's going to shoot you. Okay. A cutter like that, I'm going to go around the camera. This is actually the wrong way for me, so I'm going to turn this because it's the wrong direction for what I was doing. Go back over here. Same thing. Now you don't want the screen hanging way out, so get it as close as you can, but don't worry about a little bit hanging out there. If you really want to be anal about it, you can trim that up later. I usually don't even bother. Okay, we're going to turn it around one more time so that I can get the scissors in there as close as possible. And I'll tell you how to trim that up after we get done. Basically, you use a razor knife. So there's our screen. Okay, the next step that we have to do with this is to go ahead and put the keeper, the keeper back on for the lever and rivet that in. So that'll be our next step. Now that you have your screen on there, of course, we got to put the lever keeper back on. That's what I call this. I don't know what else to call it, but you know what this is. You saw me take it off. This is the thing that, you know, holds the lever, locks the lever down. So we got to put that on. And this is how we're going to do it. So what you want to do first is take a nail set and we're going to punch a hole where these go. Now the lever is going to be sticking through that way, right about there, through that slot, you remember. So we're going to place this right on there and rivet it in when we get done here. So let's make a couple holes first for our rivets. One right there. Okay, and as you can see, the other one goes down here. So that's for the rivets. If you've never used a rivet gun, here's what the Pop brand model K110 rivet tool looks like by Bostic. Okay, comes a little package like this. It's got a little tool for changing the ends. Read the instructions when you get it. It'll tell you how to use it, what it's good for. I use aluminum rivets. Don't use steel because they'll rust. Aluminum is easier anyway. These are 5/32 rivets. And they have a grip range of 1/16 to, I think, 3/16 or 1/8. It says so on here, whatever it is. And I can't read it because I don't have my glasses. But it says something like that. Grip range. All that means is that the grippers inside here that actuate the tool will grip anything up to and in between those two measurements. So this is one of those. You don't have to worry about it. So these are 5/32. The holes that are drilled in here are 5/32. Let me make sure I have the right one first. I may have opened the wrong package. I did. Good thing I checked because these are 1/8. They look a little small. As you know, I always show you my mistakes. Well, I almost made one there if I hadn't checked. Here's the 5/32. You can see they're quite a bit thicker. So that's what we're using on this particular job. So that fits in there like that. We open it up. There it is. All we do is push that through. Right through that hole we made, just like that. Then you just start cranking away on it, just like that. It'll pull that stem right on through until it pops, just like that. Now you've got a rivet in there. So that's really about all there is to that. We're going to do the same thing down here now. So there's your keeper. Okay.
Okay, we'll go ahead and slide the window in there. This is the open end. Centered somewhat. You want this guy centered in that channel. Okay, there we go. You see how that works. So now we're going to open it up and kind of set it there like a teepee, just like that. Okay, I want to make sure you can see this. Okay, I'll take the lever, which you remember I kept the nut and bolt on it. Bolt out of it. Okay. Open this up a bit more. I get something in there to remember that spring-loaded slidey thing. That's the lock, the lever lock. Slide that up, and we can push this through. But what I'm going to do first is grab my knife, and we're going to cut some screen. We're going to slide up the lever. Hold your mouth just right when you do this, and we're going to cut this screen just like that. See? Now while the levers are, while the slider's up, go ahead and put the lever in with the notches down, and then just let go. Stick it in a little bit like that, and then we're just going to reconnect it. We're going to close the window enough to get the end of the lever up there into the hole in that channel like that. And put the nut and bolt back in. And that's really about all there is to that. Being right-handed, I usually slide these things in from the right. Kind of got to be able to see what you're doing. And I'm looking right into the camera light. But there we go. Shake a little bit. There we go. I get a screwdriver. And turn this a little bit so I can... It's hard for me to do this in the camera. I guess I'm going to have to do it I'm going to turn it up this way. That'll be the way to do it. Turn it up this way. Much easier. Let me see if you can see that. Okay, I'm going to... I know you can. You know what I'm doing here, whether you can see it or not. But basically, we're just going to put a screwdriver in there and put the nut on the bottom. Start closing it. Now you don't want to make this too tight. You just want to make it tight, cinch it down tight enough to hold it. You don't even need pliers or anything. Just enough to where it tightens up a bit. And there you got it. And there's our window. See? There's our window. And the lever works and everything. See? All right, great. We have two more steps involved in this. And I'll show you what they are in a bit. So about the only right way to do this is to destroy it!
Oh, I don't want to be on YouTube.